My name is Sarah, and my husband is in British Army. Retention in the British Army has become a major issue in recent years, so signing off has been made harder. Gone are the days when you could buy yourself out for a month's wages and a hearthy handbag. Some desperados will opt for the tactical discharge and purposely fail a CDT test, but even that comes with a caveat now. There's no quick fix, so you have to grizz it out for the year it takes for the 7 clicks to freedom to actually handing in your ID card. One of the questions you're asked during the sign-off process is, do you want to leave because the army has been a dick? You then have to say, it's not you, it's me, babe, to admonish the army of any blame. Most soldiers sign off because they're disenchanted or, in other words, fucking fuming that they didn't get that promotion that they thought they deserved. They sign off and prepare to become a bus driver or an ice cream van driver if you re me. And then they get promoted and they sign back on and are back in love with the army again. Then they get a rubbish posting full of shithouses and cockwombles and sign off again. It should be called the 7 clicks to retention. Those that actually do leave soon realise that Civvy Street is full of absolute dirge and civvies, and they wait for the rejoiner tap to be turned back on. Most recently, pet ops and chefs were being offered £6,500 to come back to the army. I'm not sure how many of these legends have taken this generous incentive up, but I'll give them 6 months before they sign off, switch off, and start mooching around camp in mixed dress and eating biscuits with their feet firmly off the gas pedal, because a leopard never changes its spots.